This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hi folks, it's good to be with you today. My name's Jason. I'm born and bred from Oldham, Chatterton. I'm here today in the city of Manchester sharing about the good news of Jesus. I was not always a Christian. When I was a young lad, I used to fight in Oldham. Used to do a lot of fighting in Oldham. Used to take acid tabs in Oldham. I used to be a bit of a rum lad. One day, I found Jesus. And I can honestly say, it's the best thing since sliced bread. Jesus says, I am the light of the world, and we need the light of the world today. We need light. In this world, it's becoming darker and darker. We see corruption in politicians, we see ISIS on the move and the horrible things that they do. And we're living in a world that's a mess. There's an epidemic in Manchester of spice, people taking spice. And we need light in this world. We need light in Manchester. And Jesus says, I am the light of the world. He's the light of the world because he is the one that lived a life of love. Perfect love cast out fear. And he showed perfect love. A love that went to the cross. There, he went to that cross as a savior. That is the light of the world, my friends. The world is trying to solve its problem with money. The world thinks when there's a moral problem, we just throw money at it. Throw money at the national health, throw money in politics, throw money at this, money at that. But we've given billions and billions to many lands, and yet they're still in a mess because there's corruption in those lands. Till people's hearts are changed, nothing really is going to get done. We're living in an age where it's dark. We could be in a war with Korea. We could be in a war with Russia. That's the kind of world we're living in. We're living in a dark time. And Jesus says, I am the light of the world. The greatest need of the hour today is that people realize that Jesus is the light of the world. Why is he the light of the world? Well, in the Bible, it says, in the beginning, I say, are you okay? You all right? It says in the Bible, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And when we see Jesus Christ, we see the perfect man. We see the God-man, who lived a perfect life, who lived a life of love and a life of humility. But he didn't just live a perfect life, he became your savior. He became a savior for you. See, when Jesus came to earth, he didn't come to set up a political organization. Jesus didn't set up a political organization. He didn't set up a political party. He didn't set up as an emperor, as a democracy, or say, you know what, I'll set up a political party. No. He didn't see the answer to the world's problems as politics. And when Jesus came, he didn't set up a religion, neither. He didn't say to his disciples, I want you to set up a new religion. He didn't say that, neither. So Jesus didn't come to set up a political party, nor a religious party. So what did he come to do? Jesus came to die. That's why he came. His mission was to go to the cross. His mission was, I lay my life as a ransom for many. Those are the words of Jesus. Excuse me. I lay my life down a ransom for many. He says, I'm the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep. He says that he is the one that's come to mend the brokenhearted by dying on that cross. That is the message of Jesus. The message of Jesus is that he died as a savior. And when he died on that cross, it says in Romans that we are justified by faith. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. And when we believe in Jesus Christ, then we are forgiven of all our sin. But if we reject the gospel, if we reject the message, we're standing on our own righteousness. We're standing on our own morality. And if we stand before God on our own morality, then we're going to be lost, because every single one of us is lost. Jesus says, I've not come. Jesus said he's come for the lost. He's come for the lost. If you feel lost and you need God, then you will find God in Jesus Christ. Oh, he's altogether lovely. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is the Savior. He is the Majesty and Lord and Glory. He is the one who deserves praise and honor. He is the one who deserves to be worshipped. He is the one to be glorified. He is the one to be honored. He is the one who lived and died for you on that cross. He is the one that shed his blood. He is the one that died on that cross for you. He gave his life for you on that cross and shed his blood for you on that cross and died for you on that cross. Shed his blood for you on that cross. No, no, mate. Shed his blood. Shed his blood. Shed his blood for you on that cross. Shed his blood. Shed his blood. Shed his blood for you. Shed his blood for you on that cross. Shed his blood for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. You alright, mate? You alright, mate? You alright? Shed his blood for you on that cross. Yes, yes, he died for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. Have a nice holiday, guys. He shed his blood for you on that cross. Died for you on that cross. Gave his life for you on that cross. He loved you and died for you on that cross. And shed his blood for you on that cross. That's why we're here today. To share the love of God for you today. So, remember what he did for you today. Remember that he shed his blood. Remember that the Messiah loved you and died for you on that cross and gave his life for you on that cross. And if you want to know why you're here and the meaning of life, remember what he did for you on that cross. It's all at the cross, my friend. Remember that. Remember what he did for you today. I respect our armed forces. I love our armed forces. How they sacrifice their lives for us, how they give their life for us. And that's what Jesus did. He gave his life for us on that cross. He shed his blood on that cross and gave his life for us on that cross and died for us on that cross. So remember what he did for you. There is power, power, oh, underworking power in the blood of the Lamb. other is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Other is joy, joy, wonder-working joy in the blood of the Lamb. Other is joy, joy, wonder-working joy in the blood of the Lamb. There is hope, hope, wonder-working hope in the blood of the Lamb. There is hope, hope, wonder-working hope in the blood of the Lamb. Come on now. There is love, love. Put the spice away. Put the crack cocaine away. Put the ganja away. There is love, love, oh, wonder-working love in the blood of the Lamb. There is love, love, oh, wonder-working love in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, I say I, wonder-working power in the blood.
How do you do it? I love you.
Amen, amen.
I love you forever. Move along, amen.
All right, all right.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb.
No more now,
sir, no more now. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is joy, joy, wonder-working joy in the blood of the Lamb. There is joy, joy, wonder-working joy in the blood of the Lamb. Come on now, folks. Jesus died and was risen again, and he said, I am the resurrection and the life. And there is a way of conquering death. There is a way of having life today. And that is because Christ died and rose again for you. So remember that he died and rose again. And if you believe in him, one day you rise and you'll be with him. If you trust him as your Lord and Savior, if you believe in him and trust in him and have faith in him, you will die and rise with him and be with him. He gave his life and rose for you. If you trust him, you rise with him. You'll know his love, you'll know his peace if you put your faith in him and trust him as your Lord and Savior. As you trust him as your Lord and Savior, I should have faith in him and believe in him as your Lord and Savior. I say, okay.
You live once, you live happy. Yeah, and enjoy it.
Mate. God bless you. Jesus died to set us free today, to give us hope in the future. He died so that you could have a new life, new hope and vision today. So, put your faith in Him today. Find hope today in Him. There is hope. There is hope. You might think there's no hope. You might think it's getting darker with the Korean War. Maybe we might be in war. I don't know. But I know that there's hope in Jesus. I know that whether all the bombs go off, if you believe in Jesus, you're going to be safe. If you believe in Jesus, you're going to be okay. My friends, we're living in a time where we need Jesus. He is the light of the world. He is the one that you can turn to in the darkest times of your life when you feel there's no hope. There is hope because Jesus is the light of the world. There's always hope. There's always hope, my friend. Because Jesus rose again, He gives us that hope. So, in your darkest moments, when you're feeling alone, remember that you can cry out to Jesus and He'll answer you. Well, thank you.
Thank you, Esther. Thank you, Brian.
So my friends, Jesus is your hope today. He is your hope. He is your peace. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. And every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And He's Lord, my friends, and one day, every footballer will bow before Him. Every politician will bow before Him. Every scientist will bow before Him. Every philosopher will bow before Him. Every prophet will bow before Him because Jesus Christ is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He's King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of honor. He's worthy of glory. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of honor, my friends. He's worthy of honor, He's worthy of praise. His name is Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is worthy to be honored, He is worthy to be praised, He is worthy to be magnified, He is worthy to be glorified. His name is Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. God bless you, bro. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And if you want to know what the meaning of life is, look. John the Baptist said, look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Look at Him who was dying on that cross for you. And find the peace and the hope and the love of God in your life. Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus is the Savior. And He can fill you today with love. Fill you today with peace. Fill you today with joy. Fill you today with hope. If you look to Him, He will change you. If you look to Him, He'll give you peace. God bless you.
Thanks for listening, man. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you.
break.
Smoke break before?
No, but somebody's bought me a drink somewhere.
Are you drinking and you say no?
No, someone's bought me some water and some chicken. All right.
You're right, it won't take. Thanks, you know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to do it. And I've seen this guy. Then one guy.
I was brought up in Rome.
You're looking good, mate.